Westeros has mighty rivers, but none of them compare to the Roine. It is said that there is no stream or puddle in Western Essos but drains to Mother Roine. No doubt an exaggeration. Until one sees the river, at its widest, a man in the center can't see a shore to either side. The greatest of Mother Roine's children were the Roiner, a civilization as ancient and grand as old Guise. Fishers, traders, scholars, workers of wood, stone, and metal. The Roiner raised their elegant cities from the headwaters of the Roine down to her mouth, each lovelier than the last. For many centuries, the Roiner lived in relative peace. When invaders swept down from the hills, the Roiner, women and men, would don silver-scaled armor, fish-head helms, tall spears, and turtle-shell shields. If the enemy did not laugh themselves away, it was said that Mother Roine would whisper the enemy's secrets to her children, and the Roinish wizards could raise watery walls to drown their foes. Whatever magic the Roiner may have had, it wasn't enough. When Valyrian colonists first arrived, the Roiner embraced them, for all men were welcome to share the bounty of Mother Roine. Perhaps a water people should have been more cautious of strangers who exalted fire and blood. Legend has it that one day the Valyrians netted and butchered one of the giant turtles the Roiner held sacred. As a result, thousands were killed or enslaved, cities and towns were burned, drowned, and rebuilt. In these wars, the Valyrians emerged as victorious more often than not. The princes of the Roinish cities, fiercely proud of their independence, fought alone, whilst the Valyrian colonies aided one another. Eventually, the Roinish princes ceased their squabbling and united behind Prince Garen, who led the largest army Essos had ever seen against 100,000 Valyrian colonists, 100 war elephants, and 3 dragon lords. Thousands burned, but thousands more sheltered in the shallows of the river, whilst the Roinish wizards raised enormous water spouts against the foe's dragons. Roinish archers brought down 2 of the dragons, whilst the 3rd fled, wounded. And thereafter, the Roiner named Garen the Great. But Mother Valyria proved just as caring as Mother Roine. When Garen the Great marched his army against Volantis, 300 Valyrian dragons descended from the sky. Tens of thousands burned, whilst others rushed into the river. But the fires burned so hot that the water boiled and turned to steam. Garen the Great was captured alive and made to watch as Valyrians butchered every last man. So many that their blood turned the great harbor of Volantis red as far as the eye could see. Then they forced Garen to watch as they marched on his own city and enslaved all the women and children his army had left behind. The singers claim that Prince Garen called out Mother Roine to curse the Valyrians, and she in turn flooded the city with foul waters and a damp fog that caused the skin of the Valyrians to harden and crack, and thus was born Greyscale. Fearing a similar fate, another Roinish ruler, Princess Nymeria, led her own people into every ship, skiff, and raft they had, and fled Essos. Eventually, after much hardship, they landed in sun-swept and bone-dry Dorne. But we all know that tale. Now Valyria has followed the Roiner out of this world, and her daughters have grown into free cities, wealthy and powerful and proud. Still, Mother Roine flows on, past ancient ruins and bustling harbors, sweeping all man's kingdoms to the sea.